Praise the Lord, my dear brothers and sisters. Warm greetings and blessings to you from the Glory TV studios of Shalom Life Foundation, Goa, India. My dear brothers and sisters, every month you have a promised word from all of us. And today we would like to give you, or rather I would like to tell you a little bit about the prophetic word and what could be our Christmas message for the year 2019, and maybe a prophetic message for the year 2020. If you see the Bible in Luke chapter 1 and Luke chapter 2, you know, the two good chapters which are really dedicated to the prophetic words of the angel and then the birth of Jesus, conditions and situations. We're just going to do a little bit of reflection on that. If you look into Luke chapter 1, verses 26 onwards, you see the first part of it, the greetings given by the angel, and the second part is the prophecy given by the angel to the Blessed Virgin Mother Mary. Yes, my dear brothers and sisters. And then if you go to Luke chapter 2, there you see as to how the birth of Jesus takes place. The conditions, the situations in which the Blessed Mother had to go through. Then how Joseph went through along with the Blessed Mother and how it all happened. My dear brothers and sisters, when I was in prayer, the Lord revealed to me, and the Lord told me, go through the scriptures properly and you will have your Christmas message. And then when I went through the scriptures, I realized that Christmas is nothing but the fulfillment of God's word in the life of the Blessed Virgin Mother Mary. For us all now today, it speaks about the birth of Jesus, the Redeemer, the Savior coming into the world, and Jesus coming for a reason, for a purpose, to save the human race, to save the entire human race, the mankind. It's all fine, it's all perfect. But then try to see a little bit the other way. You see, Christmas or the birthday of Jesus symbolizes the fulfillment of God's spoken word in the life of the Blessed Mother Mary. Because the angel came first and gave her the greetings and told her she is the favored one. And then in the second part, the angel tells that the Holy Spirit will come upon you, the power of the Most High God will overshadow you. And then the angel tells that how she's supposed to be conceiving the child and then bring the child in the world, and he will be called Jesus, and he will be sitting on the throne of his father David and rule forever. All these are the prophetic words of the angel given by God through the angel Gabriel to the Blessed Virgin Mother Mary. And in chapter 2, you see that the birth of Jesus, in a situation most maybe unexpected by the Blessed Virgin Mother Mary. So, in chapter 1, you see the prophetic word. In chapter 2, you see the fulfillment of that prophetic word of God in the life of the Blessed Virgin Mary. So today, when we celebrate Christmas, we celebrate the birth of our Lord Jesus Christ, it is for us to know very clearly and understand that celebrating Christmas or celebrating the birth of Jesus for us is the fulfillment, celebrating the fulfillment of God's word in our personal life, the way it happened in the life of the Blessed Virgin Mother Mary. Before that prophetic word could be fulfilled in the life of the Blessed Virgin Mother Mary, see what she had to undergo. See, the Augustus came up with a serious rule that they had to go to their native land and they got to register themselves. And you see the journey from Nazareth to Bethlehem, it's around 157 to 160 kilometers approximately. Maybe it takes you around 3.5 to 4 hours by bus in today's good road conditions. But 2000 years ago, dusty, muddy roads, ups, downs, hillocks, valleys, fields, water. My dear brothers and sisters, and this journey, I'm sure, you know, happened on the donkey's back, and they had to move with the donkey, and the donkey had to carry them. So I wonder how long they could, you know, really have the donkey's ride, because besides the bumpy roads, journey on the donkey also is quite bumpy and quite jumpy. It's not a smooth ride like how we have today on bikes, or, you know, like a drive that in the car. No, donkey's back, it's like, you know, it really goes with the road, and the donkey sometimes is not very stable in its moment. It, like, sometimes it's very cool and calm, and suddenly it just has its own moods and runs fast and walks slow and all those things. But the Blessed Virgin Mother Mary and Joseph, I'm sure in those days, this journey might have taken them at least approximately around 2 to 3 days. And I'm sure they had to spend some nights somewhere, the two, three nights they may have had to spend somewhere. And finally, at the end of it, they reach Bethlehem. My dear brothers and sisters, let us look into the situation, the type of journey that she had to undergo. And she was in the 9th month, and it was time for her to bring the baby in this world. And it's at that time the decree comes out. She had to travel. We can imagine the burden and the pain, the uneasiness that she had to undergo. And then when she really reached Bethlehem, it was very late. They reached Bethlehem, but they did not reach their house. So maybe they were a few kilometers, maybe 3-4 kilometers, even 5 kilometers away from the house. But it was so dark that they could not make it. And maybe the virgin also was so tired that she could not take a step further. And all the inns were like almost closed for them, because people from different corners of the world were traveling to Bethlehem to register their names. And so everybody had closed doors for Joseph, and there was no way out. But the donkey who carried Mary knew where exactly to stop. Because if you read the book of Isaiah chapter 1 verse 3, the Bible tells that the ox knows its owner, and the donkey knows his master's manger. The donkey knows the master's manger. So it's like the ox knew where Jesus would be born, and the donkey knew very well where he had to stop. And so the right place, since the donkey knew the manger where Jesus had to be born, the donkey went and stopped there, and maybe, you know, sat flat, making way for the Blessed Mother to get up. And the entire family, the husband and wife, they had no other chance other than parking themselves in the stable there, in really terrible conditions. My dear brothers and sisters, on greeting cards and pictures, the stable and the manger looked so nice, beautiful, and well done up, you know, beautiful. But then if you really had to make a trip down to a stable somewhere, you know, you would see the stench, the smell of the dung, the urine, the insects, the flies, the worms, and not a very cozy and a pleasant place for somebody to live, you know. The animals are used to that condition, that's okay for them maybe, but today, people who take care of mangers and stables like this, they work hard to keep the place clean, and they prepare a real hygienic condition for the animals too. But 2000 years ago, I'm sure it would have been really pathetic and really terrible, like how we see it now, even today, in some villages and remote villages in India. My dear brothers and sisters, but at the end of it, come what may, God fulfilled His word in the life of the Blessed Virgin Mother Mary. He protected her through the journey. You know, He took care of her. There were lots of ups and downs which she had to undergo, but at the end of it, God is faithful, and come what may, He did fulfill His spoken word, the Rhema word, in the life of the Virgin Mother Mary. And today we celebrate the fulfillment of God's word in the life of Mother Mary. Christmas time for us is to remember and to meditate upon the word of God, which God fulfilled in the life of Mother Mary. So every time you celebrate Christmas, and especially this year, 2019, when you celebrate Christmas, remember this Christmas is to remind you that the way God fulfilled his word in the life of the Blessed Virgin Mother Mary, this Christmas God is doing the same thing in your life and in your personal life and in your family. That's what I pray, and that's what God revealed to me. And the Lord revealed to me and it told me, like, the way I fulfill the word of God, the way I fulfill the promises in the life of the Blessed Virgin Mary, same way I'm fulfilling the promised words, prophecies that have been given to you, I'm fulfilling it in your personal life. Yes, my dear brothers and sisters, I want to tell you one thing. Just imagine the ups and the downs, the tough conditions, the rough conditions what the Blessed Mother had to take up in her journey. And at the end of it, when she could not take it anymore, the worst of all was the conditions in the manger, how terrible it was. And finally, at the end of it, she gave birth to Jesus, and Jesus, the Savior and the Redeemer of this world, was born in that manger and was born in that stable. So I want to tell you, my dear brothers and sisters, each one has a prophecy in his life. God has promised his word in your life and my life. And over the period of time, we've been waiting and waiting and waiting as to when God will fulfill his word in our life. We've been waiting for quite some time. We've been praying for quite some time. And there was a time when you really gave up and you said, like, you know, looks like it's not going to happen in my life. And did really God speak to me, or was it some voice that spoke to me? Or maybe just the pastor or the man of God just spoke through his head and he went, and will it really happen in my life? You have a doubt in yourself, and you find it difficult to really believe whether that God's spoken word is going to be fulfilled in your life or not. Yes, my dear brothers and sisters, I'll tell you one thing. Your time is come. My time is come. Our time is come. This Christmas 2019 is the time where God's promised word is going to be fulfilled in your life and my life. Before you can go for your Christmas service this year, whether it's in the midnight or during the day, morning time, before you go for your Christmas service this year, I want to tell you one thing. That what was prophesied, that what was promised to you, that what was told to you by God will be fulfilled in your life unconditionally. Maybe you've had to sail through the rough times of your life. Maybe you've had an up and down journey. Maybe you have had a tough journey. Maybe you are living in unpleasant conditions right now. You can't look beyond yourself right now. Now, you just look beyond and you see everything is all dark. Maybe that's how the Virgin Mary and Joseph might have seen. You know, they were at the point from where they look ahead, they see only darkness around them. They don't see a path around them. They don't see a way that leads them to their house. And they had no other options but to be there in the stable there. Maybe in front of you also. Maybe just before you stands a pitch dark situation. Or maybe you don't see any hope in front of your head of you. And you feel you're lost somewhere. And you feel there's no way out. But my dear brothers and sisters, I want to tell you only one thing. Yes, in conditions like that, Mary, the mother of Jesus, gave birth to the baby child, Jesus. That means the birth of Jesus symbolizes the fulfillment of God's word in the life of Blessed Mary. Same way, this Christmas is the fulfilling time for you. This Christmas tells you that God's word is going to be complete and is going to be made complete in your life unconditionally. You like it or not, it's going to happen this very Christmas for you. My dear brothers and sisters, then many of us ask, like, brother, then what about the year 2020? I want to tell you only one thing. There are three beautiful things that took place after the birth of Jesus. One is the shepherds came to meet Jesus because the angel gave them the good news. Second thing is that the Holy Family, that's the family of Jesus, Mary and Joseph, they reached their home. That means after Jesus was born, I'm sure the next day the word went around and people from their houses and homes and families, they all came, because Joseph was no ordinary man. He was a very good carpenter and he was a well-known businessman in his town, in his village. And so the moment they heard that this has happened, immediately they came and took this family to their house and to their home and to their family. That's the second thing. And the third thing is that a couple of days later, in those days maybe, the wise men came to meet Jesus and the family. And when they came, they didn't come empty-handed. They came with gold, frankincense, and myrrh. Three ultimate beautiful things that took place after the birth of Jesus. The immediate next thing that we celebrate after the Christmas, after the celebrations of Christmas, after the birth of Jesus, is that we go ahead to celebrate New Year. And we are all out to get into the next year, 2020. And I just want to tell you one thing. After God's word is fulfilled in your life and my life, this Christmas, the next very important thing that's waiting to happen is that as the shepherds came and reached out to Jesus, reached out to Joseph and Mary, so in the same way, help will come to you from unexpected places. You will receive the comfort. You will receive the blessing. You will receive the help that you are in need of. Unexpectedly, you will find people at your disposal helping you out, reaching out to you, and really consoling you. That's the first place. Second thing, the Blessed Mary, Joseph, and Jesus, they reached their home, the real home in Bethlehem. Yes, reaching their homes were the destinations. Reaching their home was the destination. You too will be reaching the destinations of your life. Destinations in your career, married life, personal life, studies, you know, whatever it may be, you'll be reaching the destinations of your life. Well, that's what is there in store for you in the new year. Okay, you'll be reaching the destinations of your life. And the third very most important thing is that the wise men came and met Jesus and the family, and they worshipped him and they gave him the gold, frankincense, and myrrh. I just want to tell you one thing. The year 2020 is a year where you'll reach the peak of your prosperity, the highest level of your prosperity. You will have blessings of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. Gold, frankincense, and myrrh, they have another type of spiritual symbolic representation. Gold symbolizes prosperity, riches, material blessings. So you will find every sort of material blessings, riches, enter your house, come into your house, come into your home, come into your family. It's not that you're going to be begging for it. It's not that you're going to be running for it. It's not that you're going to be searching for it. No, it'll come to your house address. It'll come to your house. It'll come to your place. In other words, it'll come searching you first. Second thing, frankincense. It symbolizes prayer. Frankincense was a symbol to tell that, you know, when they offered incense at the altar, it was to tell that as this incense goes up to heaven, so is the prayers that we lift up to God goes up to heaven and it's heard by God in heaven. So frankincense symbolizes prayer, spirituality. So 2020 is a year where you're going to come up at spiritual level. You're going to reach the heights of a spiritual level. You will be accepted in heaven very seriously. You will go out of your way to do God's will and to fulfill God's plan in your life and the life of other people. So frankincense speaks about spirituality. Myrrh speaks about preservation. Myrrh speaks about healing. Myrrh speaks about anointing. So the third blessing is preservation of your life, healing in your life. You're looking out for physical healing, you're looking out for spiritual healing, you're looking out for preservations. Yes, your family will be preserved, your physical body will be preserved. And if at all you're suffering some complications like sickness and disorders and various other things in your flesh, yes, it will be taken care of. So 2020 is no ordinary year. 2020 is a year of material blessings, riches, glory, blessings, prosperity. It's a year of spiritual heights, prayer, prayerful life. And then also the third blessing is that it's a year of real healing, preservation, comfort, and goodness in your life. My dear brothers and sisters, your Christmas and New Year, it's all out to be exciting and exploding in your personal life. I just want to tell you one thing. This Christmas, I don't want you to remember that God fulfilled His word in the life of Mother Mary and that's it. No, I just want you to remind yourself that as God fulfilled His promised word in the life of Virgin Mother Mary or Blessed Virgin Mary, same way this very year in 2019, God is fulfilling His promised word in your life. First, second, as you're getting into the year 2020, you will receive help and comfort from people. Unexpected help will come to you. Second, you will reach the destinations of your life. May it be a career, life, future, marriage, children, anything, education, you name it, or promotions, anything, you just name it. Third, you're going to receive another threefold blessings. That's you'll receive threefold blessings. This, you know, you'll receive the highest level of material blessings in your life, expected blessings in your life, highest level of material blessings in your life. Prosperity will be like never before. Second, your spiritual height will be just awesome. You'll feel like praying and praying. You'll be getting more and more closer to God. You'll start growing in the anointing of the Lord. And third, you will be preserved. Myrrh symbolizes preservation. Myrrh symbolizes healing. Myrrh symbolizes anointing of the oil. So you will see all these beautiful things take place in your life. And so with this message, I'd like to tell you one thing. You are all out, not for an ordinary Christmas or like a Christmas like just another Christmas. No, this is not just another Christmas. It's an ultimate Christmas with a fulfillment of God's word in your life. And the year 2020 comes in with threefold blessings in your life: material blessings with prosperity, spiritual blessings with including that of your prayer life, and that healing and preservation that comes from heaven and from God. This is my prophecy for you this year and for the year to come. My dear brothers and sisters, I just want you to take this word of God very seriously in your life. And maybe I would like to encourage you to read Luke chapter 1 and Luke chapter 2 and try to see where my message of Christmas and New Year fits in the Bible with you and for all of us. Yes, this is what God told me to tell you this day. And I'd like you to share this message with as many people possible across the world, and let them also find the fulfillment of God's word in their life, and they also come into the threefold blessings in the year 2020. Can we pray? Yes. Wherever you are, just close your eyes or maybe hold for a moment and receive the anointing of the word of God. Father God in heaven, praise and thank you for this children of yours who are listening to this word of God in social media or on television. Father, we pray that as you fulfill your promised word in the life of the Blessed Mother, so are you fulfilling it in our life in this Christmas season. And then as we enter into the new year, we are all out to receive the threefold blessings of gold, frankincense, and myrrh in our life. Father, we pray the best that you have in store for us be made complete in our life, just the way you want and not the way we want. We make this prayer in Jesus' mighty name, our Lord. Amen and amen and amen. My dear brothers and sisters, through this message and through this video, I'd like to personally wish you and your family a very Merry Christmas, Happy Birthday Jesus, and a wonderful year as promised by God, year 2020, a year of threefold blessings. Blessings of prosperity, material blessings. Second, blessings, spiritual blessings. Third, preservation in healing and physical healing and spiritual healing in your personal life. My dear brothers and sisters, this is the burden that God put in my heart, and he told me to go and convey this message to the people, and I've done my part. It's your time to receive your blessings, your fulfillment of God's word, and the goodness that God has got in store for you this Christmas and in the year 2020. Till we meet again, have a wonderful Christmas, a beautiful New Year, and celebrate the love of Jesus in your heart and in the life of other people. Till we meet again, goodbye, and God bless you. A very big shalom.